Today I thought we would do something a little bit different and talk about game day in the air raid. Stay tuned. Coach, this is Coach Coltharp. Welcome back to the 92 Meshgroup channel, where we talk about all things air raid offense. If you liked what you've seen so far on the channel, we'd love for you to become a member of our community. You know, hit the subscribe button and hit that little bell down there so you can be notified when we come live. We're trying to go about every other day during the season right now. We're really excited about some things upcoming here at the 92 Meshgroup. Today I thought we would talk about something that a lot of us maybe don't focus on as much as we should. We concentrate on mesh and shallow and inside zone and screen and all this other stuff. But let's actually talk about game day. What are we going to do? We've worked all spring and all summer and all of fall camp to get this offense rolling, and then we get there on Friday night or Saturday morning, depending on where you are, and it's game day. What do we do? And so, just like in everything, you have to trust the process. And what you have to do is, when you have a process is developed from a plan. So you have to have a plan. And the number one thing about game day is this: everyone on your staff has to have a role. Now, some of us are blessed. We have six assistants on offense and six assistants on defense and all this other stuff. Some of us are, hey, there's three guys on the offense and two guys on the defense, or there's one guy on the defense and three guys on offense. However it is, and however the size of your staff is, you have to set it up based on a plan on what's most important to you. So if you're a member of the Total Air Raid System, I've just uploaded this week's bonus materials, and what it is it's a plan for game day, a plan for practice, and what coaches should be doing in practice. So if you're a member of the system, you can go down there into the materials, and you will see where it says game day plan, pregame plan, and it also talks about a pregame. It's actually called a pregame coaches meeting, and it talks about where coaches are supposed to be in practice, what their primary responsibility is. And it's a really, really great resource that I received and adapted, you know, years and years ago. And it's just something that's really served me very, very well. So if you're a member of the system, go ahead and get that. And if you'd like to be able to access those kind of things that we're going to put on the system every week, we'll do videos like we're always doing. But if you want to be a member of the system, we do have our monthly subscription. If you just want to be a system part of the system during the season, and it's $9.99 for a limited time, and you can check it out. And I'll put a link in the description for you to check that out, and we'd love to have you. So anyway, let's jump into this pregame plan, assignments and plan, and I'll talk you through it a little bit. And then, hey, in the comments down below, if there's something that you like, or you do differently, or you do better, put it in the comments, because we're all trying to learn. Sometimes it's all right to be right, but it's always better to be better. Okay, so what are our staff roles? Do we have a plan? So this is generally how we do it. Our running back coach is going to be really responsible for blitzes. He's the one that's looking for blitzes. You know, who's coming off the edge? Are they doing a Mike dog? Are they spinning? So we're having him kind of be more of a second level guy. We want him looking at blitzes, see who's coming, see who's going. He will have his eye on some stunts, but in general, I want him being the blitz guy. Wide receivers, if you're lucky, you have two guys, you know, you have an outside and inside guy. If you can do that, you can go right, left, or front side and the back side, because you want to make sure you're keeping your receivers accountable. For me, I tend to be the quarterback coach, because I feel like in our offense, if you're going to call the plays, you need to coach the quarterback. It's just my personal opinion. Doesn't mean it's right, wrong, or indifferent. You know, some of the best air raid guys in the country calling offenses at the next level are not the quarterback guy. So, you know, that's not necessarily a necessity. That's a personal opinion. But if you only have one wide receiver coach, have him look at the backside concept. You look at the front side concept. So, and what you're doing is you're holding your receivers accountable. Hey, man, you didn't give me that more route like you needed. Come on, I need you to get that guy, you know, get that guy off the hash for me. You know, I need you to, where's my take two? Those kind of things. But if you're lucky, you can have a guy watching both sides. And then your O-line coach is going to be more like your front. Hey, coach, they're in the under, they're in the over. We're seeing a lot more bear. What are those tendencies? Hey, first down, we're going to see bear front. Let's throw the screen. Those kind of things. And so you have your guys active. They're doing a job. The other thing that I would suggest is if you have a JV quarterback or a kid that's not going to play a lot, or even a specialized manager, have that kid mark down who touches the football. So if you throw it to number three, have him put a check. If you throw it to number five, you have him put a check. Trust me, the best thing about the air raid is that it gets the ball to all kind of people. And you'll know if you're having success. I promise you, when you get to halftime, if you look at your touches are spread out. If you're struggling, it's probably because you got one guy touching the ball and everybody else is just kind of chilling. Okay, so it kind of gives you an idea as a play caller who's touching the ball. So if you have a manager or a JV quarterback or somebody like that, just make them a little form up. You know, hey, check, running back has this many touches, Z has this many touches, Y has this many touches, so on and so forth. And it's also a nice way to self-scout yourself too. You can say, hey, look, in the first half, we're not throwing to the outside guys enough, or the inside guys haven't touched it enough. Maybe this is why we're struggling. So that's another way to do it at halftime. Here's a big one. Those of us who have called plays and have worn a headset, you know exactly what I'm fixing to talk about. You'll have guys in the headset who will want to play by play, you know, Tony Romo the game. Hey, coach, they're doing this and this and this and this and this, and we should do this and this and this. And then by that time, you're like, hey, man, can you just tell me what the strong safety did? You know, please don't give me the play by play, the blow by blow. Limit the suggestions. One of the ways to doing that is having people have assigned roles. And so for us, we let the running back coach be the guy that says, hey, look, maybe we should try some inside zone or outside zone, or power looks pretty good based on their stunts and fronts and things like that. The wide receiver coach is the guy who's going to suggest certain passes or screens. You know, hey, coach, they're not covering up number two on the backside. Let's look at the pedal. Gotcha. And then the O-line guy is going to be the basic run dude. He's like, hey, look, we're getting under, we're getting over, let's do this. Maybe we should try to slip screen, or hey, let's rodeo lasso. Let's get outside the pocket a little bit. We're having some trouble setting that down in the quick game. So, you know, they're going to do that part. I think if you can get something like this and you get a cohesive team together and everybody understands their roles, you'll be very effective on game day. And as we say, you know, that's what we want. We're doing all of this work. But if you don't have a plan, if you have a plan to get to the game, and then you get to the game and then all of a sudden it goes loosey-goosey, you've let yourself down. Hey, look, this is Coach Coltharp again. Thank you guys for joining us. Hit me up on Twitter at Coach Coltharp if you have any questions. Check out the website, 92meshgroup.com. And as always, spin it to win.